He can play with Argentina whenever he wants.
Klausur.
36 years old,
but don't forget, it's, Ronaldo is like 4 years younger than what he does now, according to the science or something.
Yeah.
He still, I think he can still score 15-20 goals.
If Ronaldo wants to score more goals, he probably will go to Manchester City. with better expected goal average. Yeah,
I doubt it.
Yeah, because Manchester United count on last year,
counter attack.
And now Manchester United have problem with the defensive midfielder. Yeah? Yeah, counter attack from opponents will cost them goal. Yeah, against Leeds United and Wolves, it doesn't count.
But comparing Manchester City to Manchester United, he does get a guarantee. He can play regularly in Manchester United. We don't know if he can create chemistry with Pep Guardiola.
Yeah,
we know Pep Guardiola has a set apa play strategies.
Napa? Paham nai?
Gak bisa bahasa Inggris.
Different is Ronaldo play.
I think he's got more chance to play as a target man in Man United. He connected to, as I said, to Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. He had been playing for 3-4 years in early 2000s. And it's his home for him. Everybody knows him. Everybody loves him. He's very important as a player to be supported by the fans. So I think he made for the first time a correct decision in terms of put away his ego, not to chase his ambition.
Yes.
It's come to here where he's...
Don't forget also Ronaldo moved to Manchester United. He received same salary in Juventus.
It's lower than he get in Juventus.
He got lower, but he will get the payment equally. Yeah. For example, he will get maybe 20, but 10 million he will get paid in the end. In Indonesia, it's like Depe, you know.
Yeah.
So I think money is not the issue for him.
No, money is not the issue. Same.
He just want to enjoy the play and he still wants to play at the highest level.
Yes, exactly.
I guess it's just
and that's
what he wants.
Yeah. It's important for him.
With his competition, Martial.
Even if he plays in Rancilegon, and he got crack on his knees, he gonna still play.
Okay, we're talking about the formation. If it's Ronaldo came, so someone or 2-1 or someone will be left out, isn't it? So if you're talking about the Ole Gunnar Solskjaer favorite position,
4-2-3-1.
Yeah, 4-2-3-1.
It will be. Can he still be able to do that when Ronaldo in the position?
You will play number 9, of course. His competition is with Ilvi Cavani or Greenwood, but Greenwood we know he can play at the right wing.
Yeah, yeah.
And the left wing is maybe Rashford, Martial. And we know Manchester United is already sold Daniel James to Leeds United.
Yeah.
And also, he just get competition, the real competition from Cavani and Greenwood. He's still young, he's still more time to mature.
So which one is the best position?
Number 9, of course.
Number 9. But
that's why Ole bought him.
Yeah.
That's
number 9, but without pressure, you know.
Yeah. He can play free roll.
But again,
the two center back of opponent will carry on the ball from the back because Ronaldo will show no pressure because 36 years old.
Yeah.
Okay, he's good. Okay, he's strong, but pressing it's not Ronaldo's best quality.
And we're talking about the Premier League. Now it's quite not the same with the Serie A, of course.
Yeah.
With Borussia Dortmund. Last year is so. And also, we can play with two strikers because the strikers that Manchester United have is Cavani. Cavani is number 9.
Yeah.
He's a target man.
Yeah.
And Ronaldo also number 9. He's also target man. You can have two targets.
Yeah, no.
You must have one who run, one who wait the ball. Like in Inter Milan, they used to have Lukaku and Lautaro.
Yeah, hold the ball.
In Juventus in the past, they used to have Del Piero and Trezeguet. Trezeguet and Del Piero different.
Or Del Piero and Inzaghi.
Or Del Piero and Inzaghi, different player.
Yep. And
or in Atletico Madrid, they played 4-4-2. Yeah. In the past, they have Griezmann and Diego Costa. Diego Costa is the target man, and the Griezmann is the guy who play forward and also track back to get the ball.
Yeah. If we agree, Man United will use 4-2-3-1.
Yeah.
Definitely, Ronaldo will play. It's 100%. I think we agree as
if
a target man.
Yeah. If you use 4-4-2, you will leave only two midfielders.
4-2-3-1. And I think,
yeah, if you use 4-4-2, only two midfielders.
It will expose Manchester United weakness because it's already Bruno and Pogba.
Yeah, and I think they will put a little bit forward Bruno Fernandes behind Ronaldo, right? Greenwood, maybe left Pogba or Rashford if you already fell.
Ini pancingan-pancingan ngomong kayak gini aja, kalian bisa saut-sautan sesimpel udah satu aja.
Mbak, tadi pada ngomong apa sih tadi?
Kamis.
Cara beli tanah gimana?
Kamis.
Oh, Ronaldo tadi mau beli tanah ya?
Beli tanah. Terus tadi Bes tanya gimana cara. Tuh, Abraham marah kita ke
Washington. Oh no.
Bel, lu mau belajar bahasa Spanyol, Bel? Urdu. Belajar Inggris tuh. Buat tadi pamulang ngomong bahasa Spanyol.
Siapa tahu lu bisa jadi agen pemain, Brad.
Kalau
kamu belerin gitu loh.
Kalau nanti kan agennya ada 5 ya.
Aku telat nih gue.
Udah telat
ngelapor dulu. Gue temenin. Gue mau apa kan? Gue temenin Nessa.
Gue mau bilang apa? Kakak ya udah ini the big momentnya terakhir tuh sama tadi. Sebetulnya kan kita gue lupa ingetin Panji yang perubahan nomor itu sedikit. Perubahan nomor punggung dikit doang gue lupa celeng.
Maksudnya nomor 7?
Nah, tapi udahlah. Tapi kita bahas lagi sih. Ayo aman semua kok overall.
Tintok, tintok, ish.
Kita makan, ya, kita makan
siap, mau bes. Ini apa nih bang, ish nih?
Hmm? Ini biasa buat menyambung hidup.
Tak kalah FC guys. Yang selalu di story-story player-player kita guys.
Kita cuman jualnya ke sahabat doang karena bikinnya pakai cinta ya kan. Jadi mohon maaf yang gak dapat ya. Karena berarti kita belum friend.
Tapi kalau udah nikah?
Kalau udah friend baru bisa beli cakalang. Kalau belum friend, siapa beli?
Ya jadi hari ini seperti biasa kalau udah international break agak susah bahannya. Italia tadi kan sebenarnya udah sempat di recap kemarin pas di hari ulang tahun mas.
Jadi nah, kita itu preview sih sebenarnya.
Preview iya preview.
Dan sekarang kayak jadi terminan terbukti dari kemarin yang preview di live itu.
Gak udah gitu nggak banyak momen-momen yang baru ya, menurut gue sih. Gitu-gitu aja. Isak aja itu sebenarnya gue udah
itu gua, sih gue bilang, iya. Anjing ngulik isak apa menarik
maksud gue dia kan sebenarnya konsisten ya penampilannya.
Tapi gue lupa juga, isak tuh kan sebenarnya waktu lawan Swedia yang pertandingan Euro dia kan bikin dua kali lepas ya karena blundernya para pemain Spanyol dan kemarin kan dia golnya juga karena blundernya jadi kan isak dengan gaya mainnya itu kan sebenarnya ya dia bisa bikin blunder lawan itu yang
lupa. Iya, maksudnya Spanyol juga masalahnya masih sama, Italia masalahnya sama-sama finishing touch-nya si para strikernya itu kan. Jadi gue arahin ke si Isaknya, man.
Inggris lah.
Inggris
dari
mana? Inggris dari mana? Inggris dari mana?
Inggris dari mana? Ntar mau Argentina?
Minggu depan
lah Argentina.
Menurut gue asik juga sebenarnya kalau kita bahas tuh apa sepak bola Spanyol tuh udah nggak ngetren lagi karena mereka hasilnya buruk-buruk.
Sebenarnya Tiki Taka itu kalau ada pencetak gol ininya bagus ya sebenarnya. Yeah. Tapi kalau nggak ada pencetak gol itu yang berantakan.
Cari orang yang bisa kayak dulu Fabregas, Pedro tuh nggak ada. Ya. Yes.
Oh, ini dari jual dunia apa Euro ya? Juara pakai Voltex.
Fabregas 2012.
Euro.
Fabregas 2012 Italia 4-0 kalah. Yeah. Bingung.
Yang awalnya lawan skala 1-0 di fase grup ya?
Iya. Nah, Italia udah digocek, udah dibantai.
Itu kan yang BBC.
Iya, Italia 0-0.
BBC, Buffon, ya kan Buffon, Barzagli, Bonucci, Chiellini itu kan. Fabregas di sini, dia jadi striker. Dia minta turun ke sini, bingung back Italia. Anjing gue ikutin enggak? Nih kan, diikutin, ada space di sini. Di situ terus dieksploitasi 4-0
aja. Juan Mata ngegolin itu kan.
Ini kan 0-0 ya di grup ya?
Di grup satu sama om, Dinatale. Tapi pas di itu dia pakai Fabregas kok udah susah.
Sampai Casillas minta dibelendin kan di akhir-akhir udah injury time enggak tega Mas Pak sama Itali digoyang-goyang mulu. Dia obok-obok lah istilah kata Mas Jason.
Iya. Lagi itu lagi ngetren-ngetrennya ball possession.
Nah, sebenarnya gua bilang Enrique harusnya coba kayak Ferran Torres di City gitu bisa. Daripada dia maksain Morata, Moreno.
Tapi mereka
enggak
punya. Ya dan benar-benar enggak bisa. Mereka enggak punya Ferran Torres ya. Yang Ferran Torres kan terlepas apapun dia bikin gol di pertandingan-pertandingan
penting. Buat Persap
ya.
Sekarang enggak punya. Ya, sekarang udah enggak ada yang bisa begitu paling.
Gua tanya sama gua WhatsApp Luis, gua udah bilang si Abraham Luis Mia, gua tanya, "Coach, kok kalah sih Spanyol?" nggak ada penyerang kata dia. Lah itu ada Morata, gue bilang nggak, bukan dia bukan penyerang, bukan dia penyerang bagus tapi belum hebat kata dia. Kan anak buah lu dulu coach, gue bilang iya iya bagus doang dia tapi nggak, belum di level hebat itu kata dia.
Ya andalan Villarreal tapi nggak ini ini banget ya,
maksudnya badannya gede karena suka ditolong sayap gitu ya.
Iya udah tua pak.
Kalau Mandzukic dulu taruh sayap tapi emang tipikal pemain tukang nabrak gitu kan.
Ya, rajin, rajin,
dulu,
rajin.
Strateginya Allegri buat dia supaya defense, iya, buat dia bantu defense.
Kerja keras, kalau Moreno kan defense-nya nggak begitu banyak. Di waktu duel-duel udara juga nggak sekuat Mandzukic buat jadi pemantul atau jadi duel-duel udara buat ngasih bola lepas ke striker lain.
Jangan lupa dulu Moreno di Euro dikasih kesempatan juga om.
Iya. Jadi ini tangan sama aja ya.
Sama.
Morata depan gawang gitu nggak bisa masuk.
Blok juga. Morata sama blok om.
Bener. Paling kan Indonesia tuh. Jadi host lagi hari ini.
Habis main golf kan saya.
Enggak boleh sebut Pianic ya, harusnya Pianic ya.
Ya, enggak apa-apa sama aja.
Iya. Tadi aku baru itu aku salah dengar tadi. Aku takut salah dengar makanya aku tanya Pianic.
Oh.
Nah,
iya.
Pianic ya, Pianic ya. Mending masih tuh nomor 7 Ronaldo mah. Cavani.
Bosen, ya emang buat klik sih. Bagus.
Iya.
Karena Arsenal, Barca MU, bosen banget.
Sama ternyata kan Messi dapat nomor 30 karena ngegusur juga dari si kipernya kan, kiper nomor 4-nya. Jadi artinya untuk bintang-bintang besar kayaknya ada pengecualian buat nuker-nuker nomor kayak gitu.
Iya, makasih ya, nice special.